That's what I found. God is dead, I thought. And the thought gave me vertigo. Or maybe flying over the clouds did. Either way, I panicked. If I had been able to hyperventilate, I would have. But I lacked breath, or a body for that matter. I was alone up there, and I wasn't even myself. What could I even do? Maybe it was time to reflect on things? It was. And I did. Perhaps that's why I ended up there, all by my lonesome, I wondered. But was I alone? Sophia had guided me on the path all along. If it was all meant to really end up there, I wouldn't meet her again, would I? It all seemed so anticlimactic. But of course, I wasn't alone. Her drawings were with me. They were guiding me still. And so it was that my wish came true. How could it not? Sophia, the one person who I had harmed more than anybody else in this world. If there was someone I had to ask for forgiveness, it was her. And just like that, I followed Sophia wherever she would guide me. She guided me to her death. Seeing how the water swallowed her whole again, it was too much. That's not something you want to revisit, but I was there. Maybe I could do something about it this time? In this world, I had power, abilities I had not possessed before. This time, I could save her. She was trapped. I had done this before. I could get inside and save her. This was nothing more than a final obstacle. Thank you. I had been obsessed my whole life. Not with my job, no, no. That was just a conduit, the particular way in which I had chosen to screw myself over. It was her. Always her. My father had gone into his own spiral of self-destruction after the disaster. He was more effective than me. I could have helped him. I didn't. I owed this to him as well. I was almost there. The wave, frozen in time, was being melted.